Okay, sorry for the noise in the background, but I want to be trying something new. I'm just trying this for the first time. I like this ginger juice. I used it earlier in a green matcha latte I had. But I'm going to mix it with this gelatin. I'm talking a little sluggishly because I had some oral surgery done in my mouth, so I'm trying to create some meals or some food that I can eat during this soft food adventure. So let's get started. Now this is just 2 tablespoons of this ginger juice, and I'm going to try my vanilla monk fruit. Hold on, where is it? Okay, here it is. I tried this earlier in my my green matcha latte, and it was very good. So now I'm going to try it in here. I'm going to balance this out. I guess I'm going to just use 2 tablespoons of that as well. Okay, and I put 2 tablespoons of the simple syrup in here. Next, I'm going to pour in the hot water and let the hot water blend in with this first. Okay, so here's my 2 cups of hot water. I'm sorry for the noise in the background. But you're going to sprinkle this over the top of this hot water. Okay? And that. And it's supposed to be 2 cups. And you're going to let this sit in there. Hopefully it will dissolve everything. What I wanted to do, I should have put the hot water in there first, but that's okay. I'm going to keep on mixing this until it dissolves. It needs to be dissolved, for I don't want any residue down there. Okay, well, you're going to see this little bit of foam on the top, which is fine. You can skim it off and leave it there. But you see how nice and clear that is now? Okay, now I'm going to pour that over this. Flavoring that I put in here earlier, which was the ginger juice. And what you do, you just let this refrigerate for 3 hours or overnight, which I'm going to do. And then you can cut it into squares. It's got a nice little flavor to it. It's not as sweet as I expected because I just tasted a little bit. But if you want to add more sweetener to it, like some more monk fruit or whatever sweetener you have, do so. But I'm going to seal this up and I'm going to put this in the refrigerator overnight. Now, also I wanted to mention, these are those new Rubbermaid Brilliance. I love these new containers. Now, this is a soup that I made earlier. It's a coconut Thai lemongrass soup. I believe I have a video on this already. What I love about these, they do not leak. See that? They do not leak. Now, the only reason why I would not test it with this, because this is a hot mixture, and what I love about this, when you pop this open, it has these little tiny dents to remove the heat so it can escape. Now, I'm going to try some. Let's see. This is hot. Oh, will you look at that? Wow. I wouldn't always try this at home, but let's see. Because the heat always needs somewhere to escape. And it's not leaking. It's upside down, sideways. Okay. All right, Rubbermaid. I'm sold. Oh, I heard that. Oof. That air came right out. But I'm going to let this cool for another 15 minutes. And then I'm going to put that in the refrigerator. But I do love these new Rubbermaid Brilliance. Nice, nice, nice. Love these. and stacks so nice in the refrigerator. They just stack so nicely. So if you want something that's airtight, leak-proof, and that's stackable in the refrigerator, because you know how we just store our stuff in the refrigerator and be like, oh, this can't fit, honey. These fit, honey. I love it. Okay. As you can see, this gelled very nicely. Now I'm going to, this is the gelatin ginger. I made yesterday. That's nicely. Loosen this up, and like I said, I used the gelatin, the Knox gelatin, the ginger juice, and the simple syrup, ginger juice. Wow, this is good. Yeah, I can double dip because I'm the only one eating it. Wow. You taste that ginger? And as you can see, I don't know if you can see that right here. That's what settled on the bottom. But you know, I don't want to flip it over there. Got a good flavor. See? Even though it went all through the bottom, it still gives it the good flavor that you need. What I should have put in here was some cinnamon. Man, that would have been great. Okay, well, this is Bonnie from Heart Healthy Lifestyle 60 Plus. This was a really good, tasty after dinner Jell-O. Dessert, and it's not overbearing. It's just the perfect balance of the ginger, the French vanilla, and like I said, if you want to add more of your monk fruit in there, you can, but this is perfect. Okay guys, have a great night. Bye bye.